This is CNN Breaking News.
All right, we have the breaking news. ABC News, ABC, I should say, just releasing a statement moments ago after the star Roseanne Barr went off on a racist and extremely offensive Twitter rant earlier in the day. Let's go back to our media correspondent, Brian Stelter. So what is ABC saying?
ABC has just issued a stunning statement, Wolf, that says the show has been canceled. I'll read you the two-sentence statement. Roseanne's Twitter statement, these racist remarks earlier in the day, are abhorrent, repugnant, and inconsistent with our values, and that we have decided to cancel her show. Just a short statement there from Shannon Dungy, who is the president of ABC Entertainment. By the way, Dungy, one of the most prominent African-American women in network television, in Hollywood. She and other ABC executives were horrified by these tweets earlier in the day, and they decided to pull the plug on this sitcom. It's a remarkable move, Wolf. You and I talked about this 45 minutes ago, and I told you I couldn't imagine Roseanne being fired because she was such a moneymaker for ABC. Her show was revived just a few months ago. It became one of the biggest hits on network television, drawing 10 to 20 million viewers each week. And ABC knew who they were hiring. Roseanne Barr, after all, had a long history of controversial, sometimes offensive, even racist remarks on Twitter. And yet ABC still went ahead and picked up the show because it believed it could make many millions and millions of dollars from it. However, today ABC has drawn a line here by canceling the sitcom months before it was supposed to return for a second season. A remarkable development. I have to admit, Wolf, I'm surprised. I think what ABC is trying to do here is make a statement about what is appropriate and what is going to be acceptable in mainstream America. At a time where we talk a lot about Trump's America and the strain of intolerance that has been seen recently, the idea that President Trump and his allies may be normalizing racist beliefs or racist behavior, I think what we're seeing here is Disney, one of the biggest companies in the country, trying to make a statement against that, trying to say there are certain lines you cannot cross and be employed by ABC. And this is one of them. You cannot compare a black woman, Valerie Jarrett, a former Obama aide, to an ape and still be employed by ABC.
It's not the first time she's done that either. Back in 2013, she made a comparison of Susan Rice, President Obama's national security advisor, also an African-American woman, to an ape. I won't read that tweet. The tweet that she had on Valerie Jarrett this morning was also disgusting.
Go ahead. Just briefly, I have a theory, Wolf, on what ABC might have been thinking. You know, up until now, ABC's attitude, the attitude of the executives, were that they were going to hold her nose about her tweets. You know, she had posted horrible stuff in the past. They were going to look the other way and try to get her to focus on her show, try to focus on making her sitcom, the revival, as great as it can be. But now that she crossed this line today, they felt they couldn't do that anymore. They couldn't look the other way anymore. They had to take action. ABC is losing one of its biggest sitcoms by canceling this show. It's giving up millions of dollars in revenue, but it's making a statement here about what's not acceptable in the public domain.
Let's get to Van Jones's reaction. Van, you're joining us right now. What do you think?
Well, I also did not predict this, did not expect this. But in some ways, it feels like we've been in a kind of a moral free fall for 3 years where, you know, standard after standard lowered and lowered and lowered, things that were just considered completely off the rails, out of bounds, coming out of the White House and, frankly, out of other parts of society as well. And it started to feel like there was going to be a new normal of intolerance. And this is one of the first signs that I've seen that, you know, there is a limit to how much just completely obnoxious, offensive, horrific behavior and speech is going to be tolerated, at least by people who know better, by companies, whether it's a Starbucks or whether it's a Disney. I think you're beginning to see at least corporate America step in and say, listen, enough is enough of the nonsense.
It is disgusting. And ABC, to its credit, you know, Brian, they reacted. They reacted very quickly, as you point out, earlier this hour. I asked you, you think they're going to fire her? You didn't think they would, but at least to me, it looked like, how could ABC continue with her, given these disgusting racist and anti-Semitic tweets?
A bridge too far, a line too far. There have been rumors earlier in the hour within ABC the show might get canceled, but even 30 minutes ago, one of the stars, Sarah Gilbert, who plays Roseanne's daughter on the show, she didn't seem to be aware the show was going to be canceled. Instead, she went out on Twitter and distanced herself from Roseanne and said the comments were abhorrent. I think there was an attempt to maybe save the show by just condemning Roseanne and moving on, but instead, ABC is making it very clear what is unacceptable. Earlier in the day, the word from the network was there was going to be some sort of statement, some sort of decision, and now we know they're making the boldest decision they can possibly make, which is to take a show that was a huge moneymaker, something that was promoted to advertisers 2 weeks ago here in New York as the signature part of the Tuesday night lineup, a show that was going to be bringing in tens of millions of dollars and tens of millions of viewers on a weekly basis, and go ahead and yank it because of a star's off-air behavior. But it is because that star's off-air behavior is so disgusting and racist that ABC can't stand with it. After all, ABC is known as the American Broadcasting Company. And what we are seeing here is a basic advocacy of American values. She had also, Roseanne Barr earlier in the day, posted anti-Semitic comments. She was going after George Soros, promoting a debunked conspiracy theory about him being a Nazi. Really nasty stuff that had been fact-checked and proven false years ago. But she was getting these ideas from the fever swamps of the internet. You know, fringe message boards and chat forums. People sometimes come across this stuff on Facebook or Twitter. And some people buy into it because it makes them comforted. It makes them feel good to believe the worst about the other side. In this case, she portrays liberals as the enemy, as downright evil. So Barr does that in her free time, but it hurts the show so much, it tarnishes her sitcom so much, that ABC felt it could not stand with her.
I assume, Brian, a decision like this, given all the stakes involved, isn't just the decision that ABC makes, but their parent company has to be involved as well, and the highest levels of that parent company.
Yes, Bob Iger is the head of Disney. He's the CEO of Disney. He would have been involved in this decision along with Ben Sherwood, the head of ABC, and Channing Dungey, who's the head of ABC Entertainment. Most media companies run by white men like Bob Iger, who want to make clear that they stand on the right side of history when it comes to diversity. And I think Iger is one of those men. In fact, you know, last year he was talking about running for president. He was thinking about running for president against Trump in 2020. He later backed away from those plans. He's going to be running Disney for the foreseeable future. But he's the head of Disney. And of course, Disney's a multinational company. Van was referencing this. Corporate America making a statement here. Disney also has to think about its place in the world. And it has decided it can't be associated with Roseanne Barr.
Brian, I stand by for a moment. I want to bring Cornell William Brooks, former head of the NAACP, a CNN contributor. Cornell, what's your reaction?
I'm absolutely horrified by Roseanne Barr's comments and heartened by the decision of the network to drop her show. Just to be clear here, the invocation, if we can say that, of this imagery of African-Americans or blacks as monkeys is a one with an ugly, long history in pseudoscience and stereotype. And just to be clear here, her use of this this imagery, this metaphor, is racist, is Islamophobic, but it's dangerous, right? So when we have the President of the United States referring to or implying that certain groups are ethnic, or I should say animals, and where we have a comedian comparing the senior advisor to former President Barack Obama as an ape, this is dangerous for people on the street. These stereotypes kill, they maim, they hurt. The anti-Semitism of this woman is dangerous for ordinary people. So it's not merely of offending the sensibilities of citizens, is also a matter of posing bodily injury to people. Stereotypes really hurt people. And so I'm glad that the network has dropped her, but this should be more than a cautionary note in terms of comedians or advertisers, but it should be a wake-up call, because what Roseanne Barr has said and done is characteristic of the rising hate crime in this country. And so this is a serious moment, and I'd certainly like to see our president, Donald J. Trump, who opines on a great many things, opine on this, call it out, and call it for what it is.